Okay, good morning. So I thought what I would do, I'm going to try to do this at least once a week, if not more frequently. I want to start a map out from scratch. And I know these ESRI classes, they're important to take. They're full of good knowledge. They show you how to do some introductory things within GIS. But one of the things that they sort of can't do is help you understand, like, how do I start from scratch? Like, you're going to develop a set of tools that are going to help you in your GIS endeavors, in your career and whatever. But one of the things that people always struggle with, for those just getting started in the realm of GIS, is how do I get started? So I'm interested in looking at the new Census 2020 data, which is basically stuff from 2019, right? So I thought what I would do is spend a little bit of time, at least maybe even try to do it every day, but my schedule is just kind of all jacked up. Because I'm building coordinator and for Blackburn, and just stuff that goes on that interferes with my schedule. And I have to pick up and leave the office once in a while. But I'm going to try to do this on a regular basis and walk you through basically how I would go through and create a map project from scratch. So it's going to take a little bit of time to go through this. You'll have to be a little bit patient. Some of this may be very basic and simple, but sometimes a lot of times I have to start back at ground zero on a lot of things and just kind of figure stuff out as I go. And the thing is like these videos are a way for you to look over my shoulder and see what I'm doing. And then you can go back and review these videos, back up and replay them. So in case you missed a step, you'll have the ability to go back through and review video notes. We don't often get a chance to do that in classes very often because classrooms are live, and sometimes we can't go back in time, but we sort of can if I capture all this stuff in a video. So this morning, and I'm not going to make these very long. Like this morning, basically all I'm going to basically do is come up with a question and start answering that question, and I'll show you what I mean. So the question is, so I've established that I'm interested in the new Census 2020 data. So that already tells me right there that if I want to get census data, I'm probably going to go to census.gov, and that's where we are, right here, because I went ahead and got us set up on this page. And so it says explore the census data, and the thing is like, and it is. I come with at this knowing a little bit about the census data and these pages, and they're not really the greatest. They're not easy to work with. They're not easy to help you find data. So it's really kind of unfortunate, but there's a lot of data out there. And so sometimes, how would I go about finding data that's easy to use? I could go to, like, say, for example, let's do this. Just to kind of jump off the beaten path here for a second. So every state has a data center. Like Kentucky has a state data center. I could type in Kentucky State Data Center, and the state data center is located on the grounds of the University of Louisville. So I'm interested in demographics. I could also be interested in population estimates and stuff like that, and population projections, but they're all census derived. And this is why this census data is important, and it's important for everybody to kind of fill it out, regardless of what people's political philosophies might be. Is the census is the most important basic civic action you can engage in because it determines how government monies are apportioned. It's not just about legislation and redrawing legislative districts, though that is critical as well. But it also decides how much money school districts get, and how it decides how much money cities and counties receive for grants and opportunities, and just it just basically just determines the redistribution of our taxes. And if people don't do that, or they do it wrong, then it just kind of throws everything out of balance. So it's a good civic responsibility to engage in. So I'm going to, let's just click on demographics here and see what happens. And I want, let's just start at the top and say decennial census. And they're going to redirect me towards, and I can see down here in the bottom, they're going to redirect me towards census.gov. So they're not really giving me any data that is unique to Kentucky. And if I click on population estimates, I'm going to be redirected to some other government databases. It used to be I could go to this website and let's see if I can get some. I'm going to end up right back where I was if I pick data downloads. So that's kind of frustrating, but it used to be years ago, decades, I could go to this website and, you know, they would already have data in an Excel spreadsheet, that I could download and then push into, say, my ESRI product and start mapping really quickly. But now we're redirecting towards this. So we're back where we started, sort of. I'm not going to use their search bar here because I've used it in the past and it makes it really kind of challenging to find things. Even though it looks like it's a nice setup here, I'm going to use the advanced search. So I'm bringing a little of a priori knowledge into this. I also am interested in county level data. I want to see some details. I could probably go even more detailed and look for census tracts because, like, if you can imagine, like, every county, pretty much every county, is also subdivided into what's called census tracts. And then each census tract usually has some component parts called block groups. And then even those block groups are further reduced down to what's called a block. And so we have blocks, block groups, census tracts, counties, and then states or some other kind of recognized administrative unit. So it's not really apparent what to do here either, but I noticed that as I hover over things, like, these things look active, and I know I want my geographic search criteria to be county. So I'm going to choose county, and I want to do all counties in the United States. So we're going to do all counties. I also want particular topics. So now that I have a geographic filter in place, let's pick a topic. And let's say I'm interested in education. And I'm interested in people's educational attainment. So I'm going to choose that. So I think we're done. I could choose some other things, but let's just start off simple, right? And then we'll do search. It's going to present me with a list of tables. And what looks to be the most interesting, I mean, there's a lot of tables out here. There's even actually some maps out here I could probably download and look at. Well, let's stick to the topic at hand because I want to keep this short. Let's do educational attainment. It's not going to give me a table. In fact, it tells me the table's too large to display, but I'm going to go ahead and download it. I'm going to say that I want 5-year estimates, and I want them for 2019, so I've checked that box here. And what I'm getting is I'm going to get a comma-separated value, a CSV. I'm going to get another one, I'm going to get one that's the metadata, and I'll explain that in a little bit, or maybe in the next video. I'm going to get a CSV file that's actually the data itself that I can bring into Excel. And I'm going to get a text file that's basically a description of the data that I'm downloading. So I'll click download. It's preparing my file. I'm going to download now. You'll notice that it has a crazy long name. American Community Survey. That's what this is. American Community Survey. And then there's some details in there about what year it is and the kind of data it is. It's hidden, it's buried in that code, but that code tells you. And it also tells me what kind, what year it's for, 2019. I'm going to download this. Actually, I've already downloaded it right here. So I'm going to cancel out of this. It must be a time date stamp. Let's go ahead and just do that, right? So it's going to download, and it's done. I'm going to go show in folder. I see it's appeared in the place where I wanted it to download. I am going to extract it. I'm going to put it in a folder location that actually means something to me. I'm going to call this edu-attain-2019. And then it's going to extract those files into that folder. And there it is right there. Those are the three folders. It did not lie. There's just one, two CFEs and one text file. So as we can see from the icon right here, that these will open up in Excel. And this opens up in a Word document. So let's look at this text document first. So we can see that this is actually the description of the data that we downloaded, and it's basically the metadata. This is very important because in a little while we'll talk about the legacy of data. In a few chapters away, we'll talk about the legacy of your data, the lineage of your data, and how all that data comes together. So it's important to know that where your data is derived from, because it's not good just to go out there and grab stuff and then to just use it without knowing precisely what the source and who was responsible for that data being generated. So we also have the source. So if you needed to source something in a journal or a map or a presentation, you have the source for your information right here. So a lot of the information that is the background behind the generation of this data is located in this text document. The next file that we're going to look at, and it's kind of interesting the way that the census does things. The census data, it's good data, but sometimes it takes a little while to get used to. It takes a little bit of manipulation to use. I'm going to open up this CSV file, and it will open up into Excel. All right. And I already have it open because I have a former copy of this thing. Right here. I'll bring it over. Okay, so this is the data that I downloaded, and actually that is not the one that I wanted to look at, so let me close that for a second. And let's go back and open up, not that one. I've got a lot of Excel spreadsheets open. Let's look at this one. Yeah. So this is the metadata. So the metadata is data about your data. So we looked at the descriptor, we looked at the description or the descriptive text that describes what our data set is about. The metadata is actually a spreadsheet that contains the information about our information. So it's not, you can obviously tell that it's not duplicate. So what we have here in this first column is we have the census code that's associated with the information that's being stored in the database. So every bit of information that the census data collects is attached to a database, a column in a database. And so whenever you've worked with Excel, I'm sure many of you have, you create a column, and that column has a heading, and every unique bit of information has a unique column heading. That way you can keep your information unique and peculiar to your own, to that particular record that you're capturing information for. Census data is no different. Each one of these codes represents a unique bit of information, and then the next cell over is the actual information. So, for example, and this is just the data about the data. So, what I'm going to do is we're looking at the column headings basically. They don't put the column headings in with the same spreadsheet as the actual data. They put this the code name, basically, in the column heading, and then you have to look it up into another spreadsheet to find out what that column means, and I'll show you that in a second. So in our data file, the first column is going to be S is in Sam 1501 and that code, and the data contained in that column is the total number of people age by educational attainment 18 to 24 years. So that's a number of people 18 to 24 that have answered the question educational attainment. So it's like the sample size. And then there's a margin of error. That's the second column. The third column is age by educational attainment, population 18 to 24 with less than a high school degree. Does not include GED, I don't think, or any kind of equivalency exam. So people who, maybe you dropped out of high school, but they have less than a high school education, and they're between the ages of 18 and 24. All right, let's stop right there. And here is what our data spreadsheet looks like. So we have the first column is a unique geographic identifier that specifically identifies Autauga County, Alabama. And I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. Autauga County, Alabama has this unique code. We know that there's 4,808 people who answered this question and said that they had some level of educational attainment. This is the margin of error, so we're guessing that there's less than a few percent error, 193 people, I'm guessing. So we said that the third column, and we can click right here, less than a high school graduate. So out of this population of 4,808 people, we have 601 individuals that that are between the ages of 18 and 24 that did not finish high school. And you can do some simple math here. We can figure out what the percentage is, and it looks like it's more than 10%, right? Because 10% of 4,808 is 480. So we're looking at, and we know that 20%, which would be double that, would be somewhere around 900. It would be 960, right? So we're probably looking at about 15% of the population of Autauga County did not finish high school between the ages of 18 and 24. So already we are doing some geographic work. We haven't mapped anything yet, but we're already looking at some. We're already analyzing data just by doing some simple stuff. So I'm going to finish this here. These videos tend to be they're going longer than I anticipated. I should know better. So we're at 20 minutes right now. So now we already have some data, and now I can tell by looking at this, I'm not going to be able to map it right away because I'm going to have to figure out what to do with this code. So I'll figure out what to do with that code, and then I'll make a video about that. All right, so hope this video was informative, and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.